Hi everyone. Today, we are going to set up an ESP8266 ESP01 Wi-Fi relay network for home automation. We will create the relay buttons to operate lighting and heating from a smartphone. After experimenting with different possible ways to build an ESP8266 ESP01 Wi-Fi relay network, using the wireless Modbus TCP seemed to be a preferred option. So, what is Modbus TCP? Modbus is a communication protocol that allows industrial machines to be monitored and controlled over some distance. This is done from a central device called a master or client. The machines are thus called slave or server devices. The two major types of the Modbus protocol are the RTU and the TCP. But today, we will be working with the Modbus TCP. The Modbus TCP operates over the Ethernet TCP/IP protocol. The Modbus TCP uses the Ethernet IP addressing structure on port 502 while maintaining that of the Modbus RTU. Since the Wi-Fi network operates on Ethernet TCP/IP, ESP8266 ESP01 relay modules can be programmed to function as Modbus TCP slave devices. My Wi-Fi hotspot has a network name of home, a password, a network gateway address of 192.168.1.1, and a subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. Each ESP01 relay should be programmed with this information and with its IP address. They should also have their individual Modbus addresses. Let us first program the Modbus TCP information into the ESP01 relays with FLProg from the Wi-Fi settings. Enable the client and impute your home network name and password. Double-click on Get the IP via DHCP and uncheck to obtain IP via DHCP. Impute the device IP address of 192.168.1.10, which automatically updates the subnet mask and the network gateway. Add a Modbus slave TCP with its address set to 1. Impute the port number 502 and select the built-in Wi-Fi communication device. Then add a Modbus coil and drag it into the program. Connect a T-trigger block to the output of the coil. Invert the output of the T-trigger block. Connect the output of the T-trigger block to a digital output relay tag set to GPIO01. Compile and upload the program in the Arduino IDE, but ensure that the correct reset method for your programmer is selected. Repeat these steps for more ESP01 relays, but with different IP and Modbus addresses. With the ESP01 inserted into the relay modules, light bulbs are connected to the relay's NO terminals, COM, 110 or 220 volt AC power supply as shown, and then powered by 5 to 12 volts DC. For the smartphone control, I will be using the HMI Modbus app from Google Play Store. Ensure that the smartphone is on the same hotspot as the ESP relay modules. Create a new project and select Edit Servers List from these options. Add a server and name it Relay 1. Impute the programmed ESP01 relay IP address of 192.168.1.10 and port number 502. Then test for a successful connection and add the TCP server. Add more TCP servers for the different ESP01 relays with their programmed IP addresses. Add two switches to the interface. Touch the first. Select Choose Server, and then the Relay 1 server. Touch the switch again, and select Communication Configure. The communication address should be 0 in this case. The PLC number should be 1. Allow write request, and the request type should be set momentarily. Touch the switch a final time, and select Element Settings. Select Label Settings, and change the label to Relay 1, as well as the label for On State. You can adjust the font size as desired. Repeat these steps on the other switch, with the Relay 2 server and the PLC number set to 2. Then click on the Play button to connect to the ESP relays. You can now use the button switches to turn on and off the ESP relays. Thanks for watching. Like this video if it is helpful to you, and subscribe to my channel. Bye.